Hey there, Yoyos. Today I've decided to go ahead and do a little overview of 4.5 of my favorite yo-yos of this year. These are yo-yos that I've all reviewed. Obviously, I haven't had a chance to play every yo-yo that's come out this year, so these are my personal favorites out of the ones that I've played. I usually do this at the end of my videos, but I'm going to go ahead and do this at the beginning. You can find more yo-yo reviews, in-depth reviews of each of these yo-yos, as well as unboxings and maintenance videos at sniffy-yo.com. Sniffy-yo.com. And also you can follow Sniffy at sniffy-yo on Twitter, where I post little review notes, cool stuff found, as well as some first impressions, stuff about string, all the nonsense that we're all very, very into. And there's George. Hi, George. Okay, in no particular order. First is the Greyhound. This is one of my all-time favorite yo-yos. It's an undersized yo-yo with the momentum of a full-sized yo-yo. In fact, the momentum is so great in the Greyhound, it's inspired me to start thinking about a new spec in yo-yos. That it would be cool to have a new spec in yo-yos that indicates momentum, because most of the yo-yos, or if not all of the yo-yos, that are purchased by yo-yoers are purchased online before we have a chance to throw it. And it would be a great thing to be able to sort of have an estimate of how the yo-yo moves. One of the main factors in momentum in a yo-yo is the distance of the hub to the beginning of the rim. Now, of course, obviously this has to be an estimate because we have yo-yos with all different shaped hubs, with sloping rims, and different shaped hubs and sloping hubs. But it's an interesting thing that I've been thinking about, and I think I'll do a little more on that. I'm not gonna do it. This is just a quick little video, but this yo-yo has inspired that in me. The Greyhound has a really generous catch zone. It's also got such good momentum and such a perfect weight distribution in terms of the rim that it's very forgiving on an off throw. It's got a nice big catch zone, and if you don't hit it perfectly, this yo-yo is so stable that it rights itself. So that's one fantastic factor in the Greyhound. It's also the red Canadized finish, which is an incredibly tough finish that is glossy but not sticky. A lot of times when you see a glossy finish, it's not a good grinding surface. However, the Canadized finish is so smooth that it is not sticky. It's an excellent grinding surface, and you've got this great lip for grinding. You don't have to have it at a radical angle to grind with it. I'm going to go ahead and crack it open for you, and I'm going to be putting the specs at the bottom of the screen. I'm not going to go into talking about the specs, being that this is just a quick little overview. The Greyhound comes with the wonderful CAMK bearing, the ILYY Greyhound CAMK bearing, which is extremely smooth and also long spinning. It also has the ILYY Greyhound Red Hot Silicone, which is a very precise response. It doesn't get gummy, but it has a really nice sharp response to it. It's very grippy, but it's not too hard. So it's a lot of times if you have a really hard pad, it will be too slippy. But if you have a really soft pad, then it all gets all gummed up. The hot red silicone and all of the response that I'm going to be talking about today doesn't have that factor, and it's a really precise response. This yo-yo, I found that you can hit binds no matter where you want to hit the bind, and regens are very easy. It doesn't get gummed up in regens either. This is a wonderful yo-yo, and this and all but this one are available at Yo-Yo Expert and other places. Highly recommend this, even if you're still working on getting your throw exact. This yo-yo, I think, will make you a better player. It has made me a better player. Actually, a couple of these have. But so the Greyhound from ILYY Greyhound, beautiful, beautiful finish, and just an amazing, amazing little throw. Okay, next is the ILYY Greyhound from Monkeyfinger. These guys are mad scientists. I love what these guys are doing. It's a fairly new company, it's two guys. The Mizaru has obviously this radical catch zone, very huge catch zone. However, again, the engineering with the rim to hub distribution makes this so stable that even though it's got this really radical catch zone, a lot of yo-yos that are this shape and size can be very unstable. However, this one doesn't suffer from that. It's an incredibly stable throw. It's extremely smooth. It's just a beautiful, beautiful all-around yo-yo. And also, they spent a lot of time on the anodization of this yo-yo to give it a sort of a shimmer while it's spinning. Again, this yo-yo, unfortunately, is discontinued, but it is one of my favorites of this year, so I wanted to make sure I included it. I think these guys are a company to watch. Everything they do is really interesting. And another thing that they've done recently, which I went ahead and filled this with, you can see it, they've come out with something called Snot, which is these little cirettes that contain different colored response in them. It's not just different colors, but it's also a formula that they created themselves. They formulated a flowable that has, it's a really, really nice response. It's very grippy, but it's not gummy. Again, it's a very precisely binding response. It comes in little cirettes, like I said. Each cirette can do easily two ILYYs, depending on the size of the groove for flowable. I found that each cirette you can do at least two yo-yos with, and it comes. They sell through six cirettes for $5.99. So highly recommend checking out the Snot. It's a very it's very innovative, and it's a cool little idea. And I definitely would keep an eye on Monkeyfinger, because they do some cool stuff. All right, next for this year is the Canvas from Caribou Lodge. I love this yo-yo. Not only because it has incredible momentum, which it does, it's a nice size, it's the Jensen Kimmett signature yo-yo from Caribou Lodge. It also is called the Canvas because it is an area for artwork. Now, I have not finished this. This is going to have several different layers, different colors. I need to sand it down. But being that I have to send the Greyhound back or onto the next reviewer, I wanted to make sure that I got this video out before I send it back tomorrow. So this is not finished. But what they did was a cool little idea. They created a yo-yo that has a cup that is designed to take artwork, which I think is great. I love modifying things. I'm sure that a lot of you like to modify things, so this is a cool little idea. Another thing about this yo-yo is the finish. It is a velvety smooth finish. This is a finish that's absolutely creative for grinding. It's so soft, it's almost like velvet. It's a pleasure to just hold this yo-yo, and grinding is wonderful on it. It's also got some of them have the blue response, but some of them have the snow tire response that Caribou Lodge had C3O make for them. I mix up those two companies because they're so closely named, which is a very, very grippy and really durable response. I like the snow tires quite a bit, and it comes with the Caribou Lodge bearing, which is one of the top bearings that I've played. Also, you can see here where they took a groove out of the string area, the string zone, and what they did this for two things. One is It allows them to shift more weight over to the rim, which increases the momentum, but also it takes the material out of the string zone, in a nice area of the string zone, which allows you to do multiple wraps and without it getting caught up in itself. It's a great idea. So the canvas from Caribou Lodge. Again, all of these yo-yos have very, very in-depth technical reviews on the blog, so this is just a quick overview, but I would have to say that the canvas is a wonderful, wonderful yo-yo. Next is the Paul Dang from OneDrop Yo-Yos. I have to say that this yo-yo has made me a better player. It's a very precise yo-yo. It's not as forgiving as the other ones that I've talked about so far. It requires a lot of more attention, and because of that, it's made me a better player, made me a more attentive player. It's a very fast yo-yo, and it's a very hoppy yo-yo. I found that this yo-yo, I think about yo-yos as if they're percussion instruments. I'm a drummer. I've been playing drums all my life. One of the things that I do when I'm playing, I like to play polyrhythms, play multiple rhythms at once. And I have excellent limb independence. I can play in three with my feet and be playing another time with my arms, or two different time with my arms. The yo-yo to me is almost like the lower half of a tabla. A tabla, the Indian instrument, consists of two drums, a high one and then a low one, which bends notes. And I think in large blocks of time when I'm playing a yo-yo. And I found that this yo-yo has given me this new insight into playing a yo-yo between the rhythm, in weaving it in and out of the rhythm of the music that I'm listening to. And I've been listening to Pole a lot while I'm playing this yo-yo, which I highly recommend checking out Pole. This yo-yo is very, very precise, and again, like I said, it requires a little bit of attention in order. It's not forgiving in terms of off throws. However, it moves so quickly, and it's got the pure matte finish, which is a wonderful grinding surface, and it's impossibly tough. My playing area is outdoors. My apartments have very low ceilings. My apartment has very low ceilings. I only have one apartment. So I built a testing area outdoors for when I'm playing yo-yos that I'm reviewing. And it's a carpeted area that's got a very thin carpet over concrete. And this has hit the carpet a few times, and the finish hasn't suffered at all for it. It's highly grindable, very tough. This is the Wasp edition, which is an acid wash edition of the Dang. There are no more of the Wasp edition left. However, I did notice on Yo-Yo Expert they do have another edition that's very similar to the Wasp edition, except it doesn't have the aluminum shining through. So the Dang also has a very, very generous cup, so you can do grinding even though it doesn't have a lip. You can grind without it being at too radical of an angle. The cup is so large, and the pure matte finish is so smooth and grindable that grinding in the cup is not an issue, even though it doesn't have a lip. Crack it open for you. The Dang also has a very large space between the catch zone and the response. The response is the OneDrop flow groove pads, which is absolutely one of my favorite types of response. It doesn't get gummy, but it's soft and grippy. It's pretty perfect. It's a very precise response, and it's got this space in between the response and the catch zone, which allows for multiple string wraps without it getting caught up in itself. It also has the grooves that OneDrop has gone back to putting in their yo-yos, which I really like. The Deets didn't have the grooves, but then when they came out with the Dang, it does have the grooves, which lower the amount of material that's coming in contact with the grind, so there's less friction, and it allows for a longer grind, and it also sort of zeroes in the string. The Dang also uses the side effects system, which is the interchangeable hub system that OneDrop's created, which is great because you can change out your hubs for color. There's different colors of each hub, different materials. There's brass and there's aluminum and different weights. So you can kind of customize your own yo-yo. The Paul Dang comes with the ultralights, which I think are pretty perfect. It does, even though this the yo-yo has doesn't have a lip and doesn't have that much material in the rim, it creates a ratio that gives it lets it have a fair amount of momentum because of the ultralights. And I think I mentioned, if I didn't, then I'll mention it now, the Paul Dang and all OneDrop yo-yos, all of their high-end yo-yos, come with the insanely smooth and long-spinning OneDrop 10-ball bearing. This yo-yo, I don't know if I said this, but this yo-yo has made me a better player. It's given me a whole new understanding of yo-yo as percussion instrument, which may sound silly, although it may make sense. And then the one half, this is the St.eel, also from ILYY Yo-Yo. This is a miniature yo-yo that doesn't sacrifice anything for its size. It's a pocket yo-yo, however, it's made of stainless steel, so it's very substantial. It's very nice and heavy. It's got a great grinding lip. It's again really well engineered in terms of the amount of material that's in the rim compared to the distance from the hub. It's got a nice little pointy hub, which is a nice for doing matadors. And it's also, even though it's a very small yo-yo, it's got a really nice curved catch zone. So, and it's also, because it's got so much rim weight, it is forgiving on a on and off throw. So although it's a very small yo-yo, it catches like a full size. I throw this in my pocket, and when I'm playing it, I don't feel like I'm sacrificing anything for having a pocket yo-yo. Also, even though it has an undersized bearing, which a lot of people, including myself, generally don't like, it, again, there's no sacrifice. This bearing is incredibly long spinning, and because this yo-yo has so much momentum and is engineered so well, I haven't found myself hitting on the small bearing like I do with other small bearing yo-yos. I haven't noticed it. In fact, it has not been anything that I've thought about while playing this yo-yo. That's how well this yo-yo is made. And it also has the ILYY Yo-Yo hot red silicone, which again is a great response material. If you're looking for a pocket yo-yo, I highly recommend this. So, those are my favorites for the year, out of the ones that I have played. Again, this is my opinion. I usually stick to fairly dry technical reviews, but I decided to go ahead and do this one, give you my opinion on these, and I'm interested in what your opinions are. I'm going to go ahead and do something about string as well in the future. I think about string a lot, which I'm sure that you probably do too. We all think about string a little more than normal people do, so I'm going to do a little thing on string. I've been playing some really interesting stuff lately. All right. Thanks.